That's right, y'all. So if y'all don't know Javier, he has a fierce family behind him. Y'all see them behind us, y'all. This is his family. He's been living here in the Bronx. He's a New Yorker. He's been here since he was 7 years old, y'all. And now we have a criminal government trying to kidnap him out the streets. And we ain't gonna let him. We ain't gonna let him. So next up, so y'all can get to know Javier more, is his mom, Alma, who's just... Please give it up for Alma. Can tell you more about Javier and why we're...
Gracias a todos por su apoyo incondicional, porque a pesar de que ya vamos a hacer un mes de que estamos viniendo cada día, reuniéndonos por la libertad de mi hijo, siempre han estado presentes. I'm gonna say thank you to everybody to coming here to us to support for this cause, because even with this almost a month, we're gonna be here, always we say present, always we say we're here for you. Let me tell you this one, when we start this protest, always, you know, I was kind of scared because my color. And I kind of scared because even the same family sometimes, the same people we consider as friends, if they ask, they say, oh, we're gonna call the immigration on you, we're gonna do this on you, we're gonna call the police. Voy a darle las gracias porque, y a decirles que a pesar de que hace un mes, yo tenía miedo. Miedo, como dicen, de salir a la luz, de salir de las sombras, por mi color. Porque parece que en este lado del mundo, tener este precioso color les intimida, les da miedo, porque les gusta este color, porque cuando viene el verano todo el mundo quiere tener este color, pero no les gusta, les da asco, se vuelven racistas, se vuelven xenofóbicos, incluso nuestra propia raza trata de intimidarnos. When I start this fight for my son, before I feel I was, no alone, but I told you just I got my family and a couple of friends. But with the first time we came here, even with a, when you feel a 0 degree, and I see all the people, they give me the strength to continue. And that day I say, I never was afraid to fight and working on the hospital. 2-3 shifts with the pandemic. Why I had to be afraid to fight for my son?
That's right.
Why? Right. Cuando la pandemia empezó en su apogeo, cuando eran 500, 600 muertos, no tuve miedo a trabajar 2-3 turnos en un hospital. ¿Por qué hoy yo voy a tener miedo de pelear por mi hijo? Que no merece estar tras una celda. Y lo digo así porque tenemos 11,000 firmas. We have almost more than 11,000 signs behind us. Respond and support us. Tenemos muchas cartas. No de cualquier vecino, pero claro, importa. Pero tenemos de congresistas, de senadores, de directores de programas donde mi hijo asistió y participó. Nosotros no hemos venido a quitarles nada a esta comunidad. We never came here to take it off nothing from this community. We came to give back to this community.
That's right.
As a teacher, I was working for 11 years on the school. I working for 20 years at the hospital. And I feel proud. I feel really proud. And always I told my kids, you have to do the right thing. Why? Because when you need something, you're gonna get the support. Siempre les enseñé a mis hijos, vamos a hacer lo mejor que podemos por esta comunidad. Porque cuando nosotros necesitemos de esta comunidad, la comunidad sin pensarlo va a decir, estamos aquí. Y la comunidad está aquí. Ustedes están aquí conmigo. Entonces, ¿qué yo más puedo pedir? Que mi hijo sea liberado. Están diciendo, siempre que deportan un inmigrante, deportamos criminales. Mi hijo no es un criminal. Incluso por ser indocumentado, no es un criminal. El crimen lo cometí yo. Como madre, lo traje yo. Yo fui la que decidí traer a mi hijo a un mejor futuro. ¿Quién de ustedes no haría algo así por un hijo? ¿Quién? ¿Quién? Tal vez el que no es madre, tal vez el que no es padre, el que no quiere un hermano, el que no quiere su hijo. Pero les juro que si ustedes tienen la necesidad de traer a su hijo huyendo de las maras, huyendo y evitando que su hijo se convierta en un delincuente, prefiere correr el riesgo y que sea un indocumentado. Por eso nos venimos. I never came here because we are criminals. We came here because we're waiting and we're looking for a better future. I know most of you, all the time we hear, oh, we deported criminals. No, you have to clarify what kind of criminals you deported. You don't have to stereotype a criminal. No, my son, he wasn't a criminal. I am the criminal as a mother because I am the one decide from to him here. Tengo un, dije, una medalla de la Estatua de la Libertad. Mi hija me la dio como 4 años y yo le dije, oh, me diste esta medalla porque vivimos en Nueva York. Y él me dijo, no, mami, porque me trajo a la tierra de la libertad. 4 years, like 4 years ago, my son gave me a charm with the Statue of Liberty. And I asked him, what is the reason? Because we live in New York. And he said, no, mommy, I gave you because thanks to you, I live on the freedom country. Y qué ironía, 14 meses detrás de las rejas. ¿Por qué? Porque ese día los policías tenían que cumplir con una cuota. Y dijeron, oh, se cruzó la calle. Vamos a agarrarlo. Tenemos los videos. Y entonces, como madre, ¿cómo creen que ustedes, que yo me siento? ¿Cuántos de ustedes no traerían a sus hijos? ¿Cuántos de ustedes no arrancarían a sus hijos de las garras de una pandilla? Prefiero ver a mi hijo como un indocumentado, a verlo como un criminal, o verlo muerto en las garras de una ganga. I prefer, you know, see my son as a indocument here, as see him a criminal. So, ICE, you better stop the game, okay? Today, I feel more comfortable. Disappointed, totally disappointed. De verdad, hoy me siento más fuerte, pero totalmente desencantada del sistema. ¿Por qué? Porque eso es como cuando nosotros decimos, ok. Eso es como cuando nosotros decimos, ok, voy a contratar un empleado, pero ese empleado puede hacer lo que se le pegue la regalada gana. I got a new employee, and that employee has to do whatever they want because I don't get a time to supervise. I don't get a time to pay attention what they do, so they do whatever they want. Cuando yo contrate a un empleado, voy a tratar de supervisarlo. Voy a delegar cada persona. Yo entiendo que el presidente Biden no está encima de los que están tomando las decisiones aquí, pero tienen que tener sus delegados. Para que esa persona rinda cuenta qué es lo que está haciendo María, qué es lo que está haciendo Juan. As I said before, I'm here for my son. I'm really proud to be his mom. Estoy aquí por mi hijo. Estoy muy orgullosa de ser su madre. Pero estoy también aquí por la madre de muchas personas que tienen miedo a hablar. Porque creen que ahí se los va a llevar ese mismo día. Porque creen que al final todos nos van a señalar porque somos indocumentados. ¿Somos indocumentados? Sí, pero somos trabajadores. Personas que venimos aquí a recoger hortalizas, a ser de babysitter, a ser de maestros, a limpiar hospitales, a hacer tickets para que sus pacientes tengan su comida a tiempo. Estoy muy orgullosa de ser inmigrante y estoy muy orgullosa de tener este color. Gracias.
When immigrants are under attack, what do we do? That's right. Powerful words. Powerful words from Alma. You know, a child.
Que queremos.
Justicia. That's who they're attacking. That's who the United States government. The greatest, supposedly the greatest democracy in the world.
We're a gang here, right? Doing the same shit. So, first of all, I want to thank you because you've been with us for a little while already. It's going to be a month. and we keep fighting for the same thing. Well, we're fighting for a right to be free.
That's right.
Because that's our right, freedom.
That's right.
That's right.
My skin shouldn't decide if I run free in the street or if I have to be in jail.
That's right.
That's right.
So estamos aquí ya casi un mes. Y lo único que pedimos es nuestro derecho de ser libre. Mi color no tiene que decidir si yo me quedo aquí en la calle o me meten ahí.
Yeah.
¿Por qué no estamos aquí? I gotta ask this. What are we doing here all the time? These people over there, they don't care though. They don't give a fuck about us anymore. So we keep doing it here. Why? We do it here because it's a community event. Because we do it in the park. Because we are getting united. But let's be honest. We are here not asking President Joe Biden in President's Day to give a fuck about immigrants. We're demanding it because it's our right. We pay taxes, we deserve to live a dignified life. So, estamos aquí. On President's Day, el Día de los Presidentes, y le vamos a pedir al presidente Joe Biden, y no se lo estamos pidiendo por favor, es una demanda. Tenemos derechos, exigimos nuestros derechos. Nosotros ya no somos humanos tercermundistas. Vivimos aquí, apoyamos la comunidad, pagamos impuestos y nos merecemos los mismos derechos. So we want rights for all immigrant community, no matter what color of skin we are. We want rights for our immigrant community, no matter what you decide to do with your body, what sexual orientation you are. We have our rights, we need dignity, and we need freedom. So, President Biden, y cualquiera que está jugando ahí en Washington a ser gobierno, because you know, until you learn, you won't do anything. So, queremos libertad, dignidad, justicia, para nuestra comunidad inmigrante, no importa el color de nuestra piel, no importa nuestra orientación sexual y no importa si hablamos inglés o no, porque al final del día we pay taxes.
Yes, we do.
Y si a los republicanos algún día les dejan coger el poder, porque parece que lo tienen bien agarrado, o si algún día los demócratas se ponen los pantalones y cogen el poder que dicen tener, so we're gonna be here fighting and waiting to the day that you give a fuck about the immigrant community, because we're tired already. We're tired.
Yeah!
Yeah! Woo!
I thank you all for being here. We're here for Javier. And I want to start this off by saying thank you to Javier's family for trusting and allowing us to organize a march in his honor. I can't begin to imagine how traumatic this has been for you. To see your relative be punished for something he has no control over and had no say in is despicable. Javier is in jail because he came to this country when he was seven. When he was fucking seven! We are here because the US government has nothing better to do than target and terrorize black and Latino people. And ICE is the US government. It doesn't matter if they sell you the illusion that ICE is a rogue agency. Anything that is rogue or opposite of America, America destroys. Ask the Black Panthers. ICE is as American as apple pie. The United States was founded and survives on persecuting black and brown people for doing the same things their ancestors did. Javier has lived in this country for two decades. This is his home. And if the place he calls home will do this to him, what do you think it will do to you? See, liberals and buffoons, there's really no difference. But liberals and buffoons think this is just a Latino issue, when in reality it's a basic human compassion issue. It's fucking basic human empathy. I'm so tired of hearing how these people just need to be educated. Well, educate this. Black and brown people will no longer be your teachers for why you can't get your head out your ass. Why you can't feel for another human being suffering. Black and brown people are murdered every day, stolen from their homes every day, have to fight to survive every day, and then have to prove to your sociopathic ass about why you should give a shit? No more. Dariella is one of the bravest people I ever met, but Dariella shouldn't have to be brave. I shouldn't have to give these speeches. You shouldn't have to be here putting your bodies on the line in resistance of a country you know doesn't care about you.
Our trauma is not our badge of honor. It's our proof we exist in a country that tries to erase us every day. Javier had an interview with an ICE officer to see if he would get released. And ICE headquarters in DC were supposed to go through everything and make a decision. But ICE here just denied that without waiting for the case to get renewed. This whole thing has been an exercise in cruelty and emotional torture. Javier's family shouldn't have to go through this. No human being should. Dariella shouldn't have to have her heart broken every day. Do you know how much hope costs? To put your whole heart into something? To hold out hope that your brother might be free from this concentration camp? For these Nazis here to just say no. To just say no. ICE and Nazis are no different. Just like Democrats and Republicans. And Libs, I hate to break your heart like this. I really wish you could go back to your Friends episode. But we never had a Friends episode to fucking begin with. ICE ripped families apart and America ripped me from my home, my culture, my heritage to be in bondage and then blamed for my suffering. To black people here, do you know how many black immigrants are in ICE custody? 44% of people in ICE custody are Haitian immigrants. They stole us from our land and put us here and now detain and remove other black people from wanting to be here. How can we not be enraged? How can I not dedicate my life to burning this entire shit down so black and brown boys and girls never have to go through an ounce of the trauma we all have?
Talk it.
We all will be in concentration camps if we waiting for Kamala Harris or Joe Biden to save us. We will not stop until Javier and every person in ICE custody is free, and ICE is a boss and burns in hell where it belongs. They want us to pull ourselves up by the bootstraps. Well, my advice to them is this. Be careful, you might not like the boots we use. I dedicate this unbelievably long-ass speech to Javier's family. I love you, appreciate you, and admire your courage for even being here. If we all have even half of their beauty, power, and strength, then this country doesn't stand a motherfucking chance. You are a light and inspiration to us all. And Dariella, you are one of the most beautiful, sweet, kind-hearted, and strong people I have ever met. And I'll be goddamned if the only consolation we have for you at the end of this is saying you're brave. Thank you.
A show of support for Javier Castillo Maratiaga, a Bronx resident and former DACA recipient who was taken into ICE custody. Maratiaga was born in Honduras but came to the U.S. at the age of 7. He was previously protected under the DREAM Act, but his family says he didn't renew his DACA status in 2019 out of fear of sharing personal information. Maratiaga was said to be sent back to Honduras in January, but the deportation deportation was delayed. And although President Joe Biden's 100-day plan includes a path to citizenship for people like Mara Diaga, activists at Monday's rally stressed the need for immigration reform, no matter who is in office. Mara Diaga's mother says she doesn't want her son to suffer for a mistake he didn't make.
I am the criminal. I am the one brought here. He was 7 years old. Who can decide? Explain to me, who can decide to go to another country at 7 years old? As a mom, it's just the crime I did. It's just looking for the better future for my kid.
Amara Diaga is currently being held at Hudson County Correctional Facility.